About 5.5 months ago, I left my husband, my two kids, who were 3 and 5 at the time, in LA, and I flew back by myself to China. My mother has late stage cancer, and I came back to help my dad take care of her. I have been in and out of the hospital with my mom over the last 5.5 months. But since the beginning of August, we've been living in the hospital ever since. Because of COVID, only one person is allowed to stay with the patient. I usually spend about 2 to 3 weeks in the hospital with my mom, and then my dad will switch me out for a few days to let me rest. And since the end of September, right after the harvest full moon, things got super intense as my mom's condition rapidly deteriorated. The days and nights became sleepless, and I was both emotionally and physically exhausted. As things got tougher, I had to become even more present with myself, my feelings, and with my mother, so that I could continue to give her the kind of care that I want to give her. Because of how tiring it is right now to care for my mom, I only took a 3-day break this last time because I didn't want my dad to overexert himself. As usual, the first day away from the hospital is usually spent in solitude and sadness because everything outside of the hospital reminds me of my mom and how these things and places will never see her again. Knowing the drill, I picked myself up on the second day and went out into the world. You know what's really sad? I would say 90% of the people that live in cities in China have probably never sat next to a campfire. Like a real campfire burning wood, you know, out in nature, like under the stars, and just sitting next to it and just absorbing the heat from a real fire. There is nothing that can really replace the quality of the heat from like a real wood burning fire. There is something so healing about it. I mean, even these candles right now, like I'm sitting here, I could feel them. Like this fire, I feel it. Like it's so healing. Even though the fires are, even though the heat sources are so tiny, but I really feel their energy. Like there is a different type of heat that completely envelops me. And it feels so good. And honestly, I can't wait to go home, go to my backyard and start a fire. I think that's the first thing I'm gonna do when I get home. I better remember that. Back in the days, people used to use incense as a clock. In China, sometimes we say in the time of one incense or two incense or half incense, that's like a, it's a measurement for time. You know, life is all about finding a sweet spot in everything you do. And this is why I think surfing is such a beautiful metaphor for life in general, even though I don't surf. But when I see people waiting for the waves, and I feel like I really admire how patient people can be. And you know, life is about patience. You can't force a wave to come to you, you know? You can't force it. You have to wait. You have to wait for the right wave. You have to be in the right spot to catch the wave. And once you catch the wave, you can't control how the wave behaves. You adjust yourself by feeling out the wave, you know? And you're constantly shifting on your surfboard and finding that sweet spot. Because the wave is constantly changing. It's never the same. And you're constantly adjusting yourself. You never blame the wave. You never say, oh, I'm such a victim of this wave when you don't surf a wave well. I mean, what you do is you keep at it and you keep trying to improve your skills, right? You keep trying to get better at it. It's all about accepting and being in the flow and not forcing, because you can't, there's nothing to force when you're in the water. I mean, water is just amazing. Water is always shifting, shape-shifting, and it's energy, but in a physical form. Like it's so fluid, and energy is fluid, but we can't really see it. Water is one of the best teachers in life. The Chinese have a saying that water is the highest form of compassion. 上善若水. It basically means that water is a bearer of wisdom. If we could truly respect water as our teacher and truly learn from it, we would be living in a much, much more peaceful world. Yeah.